There is a reason why I haven't purchased a new MacBook Pro in over 7 years. In my opinion, they've been a little sucky lately. But the good news is, reportedly, Apple is backpedaling on a lot of the choices they made with the newer MacBook Pros, and a brand new super awesome MacBook Pro is coming up real soon. So let's talk all about this stuff right now. Hey guys, how are you all doing? If you're new here, welcome. My name is Krazy Ken, and today I'm just going on a bit of a semi-rant with all of you about Apple's MacBook Pro and where it's going to be going in the future. Now, this is a looser freestyle episode, so I guess if you want, feel free to just play me in another tab while you do something else. But if you do that, I'll miss you. So in my opinion, the 2016 MacBook Pro is Apple's worst MacBook Pro ever. I think they just jumped the gun too much and changed way too much at once. First off, they killed all the ports. Everything is USB-C / Thunderbolt 3. They do have a headphone jack on there at least, thank goodness, but that wasn't the greatest decision in my opinion. They also got rid of MagSafe, which is a feature I personally don't care about very much, but it's still really cool and it's a safe way to keep your stuff charging. But they got rid of that too. And one of the worst things by far is this butterfly keyboard. Not only does it feel weird, but the failure rate is so freaking high, I was never confident about buying a new MacBook Pro. At my day job office, I have heard of several stories about employees getting stuck keys, and I just can't take that chance when I'm on the go. And in my opinion, the whole butterfly thing could have been easily avoided. I think Apple was trying to fix an issue that didn't really exist. They were talking about how keycaps wiggle and all this stuff, and they want to make them more stable and increase the surface area. But did anyone really complain about that problem in the first place? I mean, you know, you guys let me know what you think. I don't want to speak for you, but I have never had a problem typing on this traditional looking chiclet style keyboard ever. Now, the newer one does feel a little bit weird. I got used to it, but still, the probability of the failure rates and everything just made me very cautious about purchasing a MacBook Pro. Speaking of the keyboard, the touch bar. I do not see the point of this touch bar thing at all. I tried to be open-minded and I tried to be thinking forward and I tried to think, wow, this can be so good, but I just can't. I've tried it and there's ways to make it work. It's actually very customizable, which is really cool, but not having the tactile feeling of a physical row of keys just slows me down, especially as a pro that uses a lot of keyboard shortcuts. Having to constantly look down to see where I'm tapping just slows me down way too much. It's kind of distracting. And a part of that touch bar issue is no escape key. They got rid of the escape key, so just years of muscle memory going up to the upper left to press the escape key were just immediately destroyed. The more I think about it, like half of these issues have to do with the keyboard layout, and it seems like all of this stuff could have been completely avoided. I really don't know what was going on through Apple's head. Now, yes, they like to try to change things and be innovative and everything, but they're not perfect. You can't win them all. But let's talk about some positives. The computer is faster. If there's no thermal throttling issues, it's usually faster. I like the bigger trackpad. The speakers are really nice too, so that's really cool. And I do like the design. I like the space gray and the thinness, but overall, that's not enough to sell me. But the good news is Apple has already fixed a few things with their upgraded computers. They tried a second generation butterfly switch for these butterfly keys, but they eventually did away with that with the 16-inch MacBook Pro. They went back to the scissor switch, which I think was a way better idea. They should have just stuck with that in the first place. They also added an escape key back, which is great. But other than that, not much has changed. But those are two big things still. And if I had to buy a new MacBook Pro, I think I could get along with that because that addresses some major issues with the keyboard, a fundamental part of interfacing with your computer. My big issue, in addition to the keyboard stuff, is the ports. Now, I was willing to go the dongle life, you know? I was willing to go the extra mile and get all these dongles and stuff for the USB-C ports, but it's just kind of a pain in the Not to mention, they also removed the SD card slot, which is super handy. I shit you not, guys, 20 minutes before I started taping this, I got a message from someone who was at a video shoot and they needed an SD card dongle. This is still a big issue. Cameras use SD cards, people. So many of them do, unless you're using CFast or like SSD modules on a RET or something. Like most of the time you're gonna be using SD cards, and it's still a problem where if you're on location on a shoot and your adapter dies or you forget to bring your adapter, you're screwed. And I get that Apple wants to help push the world forward, but here's the problem. There's way too many frickin' devices using USB Type-A still. Too many people rely on it. Trust me, I would love everything to go Thunderbolt and everything. It's all one connection for Thunderbolt 3. It's super fast, and I use a Thunderbolt 3 RAID, and it's frickin' awesome, but hardly anything uses that type of connector, and it's just impossible to fit in. Now, some might say, oh, Ken, they killed the SCSI port and went to USB on the iMac. They pushed forward for that. Sure, and I think that's great. But we have to remember, how many people were using personal computers back then? How many SCSI devices were there back then? A lot less. The transition, although still kind of hard to do, was much more manageable back then, in my opinion, because there were fewer devices and fewer people that needed to make the switch. Nowadays, there's bajillions of USB Type-A devices and over, how many personal computer users are there? Not just Macs, but in general, like a billion, 2 billion? Like, it's insanely high. And transitioning that is just way too complex for now. But here's the even better news. Word on the street is that we're going to be seeing new 16 and 14 inch MacBook Pros, not only with the really fast, really efficient Apple Silicon chips in them, but also with other feature changes, including a new redesign, which is inspired by the iPad Pro design language, which I'm really excited to see. But Apple is also reversing their decisions on a few things. Reportedly, MagSafe is making its way back into the computer. For those who don't know, it's designed so if someone trips over your power cord, it just comes out and doesn't yank your computer off the desk. But I don't think that's ever happened to me in my life, ever. If it's happened to one of you guys, let me know. Sorry for your loss. Also, the touch bar is likely going away, which, thank you, Apple. I still don't see the point of the touch bar. Guys, if you like it, let me know. I'm trying to be open-minded and thinking about new technologies and stuff. You know, let me know what I might be missing. But I'd rather have a physical row of function keys any day of the week. And more ports are coming back. They're gonna bring back USB Type-A. Maybe other connections too. I do like that this computer has HDMI on it as well, but you know, if I have to trade that off, whatever. USB Type-A is the main thing I'd like to see come back. And we also might see the SD card slot come back, which is a big deal to me because guys, tons of people still use these. I mean, coincidentally, I don't. I shoot with a Blackmagic camera and I shoot onto CFast media. So I still need an adapter either way, but my Canon DSLR shoots SD cards. And I'm glad that Apple isn't so stuck up where they're willing to subtly admit they were dead wrong with a lot of these choices. And the backpedaling will actually make a lot of people super happy. But what about the future? What are we gonna see after that new generation of product? Well, we're gonna maybe see mini LED displays, which will help reduce blooming and keep those blacks nice and black without, again, the blooming effects around colors. There could be OLED. There's some rumors going around about OLED displays, but there's a lot of talk about it actually being mini LED that Apple uses. And there's also talk about Face ID being integrated into the display, kind of like what you use on your phone. So that could be nice too. Hopefully they still keep Touch ID. I think Touch ID is a nice move they made with the computer, but Face ID would also be pretty convenient. But we're likely not gonna see that stuff in this next release because, well, one, Apple needs to be able to work on the right amount of stuff and not do too much at one time. But also what I think is really important is they gotta stagger their features. They can't just release everything at once. You know, you gotta release some great stuff here and then, you know, 9 months down the road or whatever, release some great stuff here. Don't just do everything at once because then you're just gonna, you know, burn yourself out and peak right there. But let me know in the comments, let me know about things you like with the newer computers and about things you don't like. And also what you're looking forward to with the new 2021 models and so on. I keep hitting this display. I'm gonna slice my hand open. This thing is sharp. Okay, not really, it's just thin. So subscribe and stay tuned because as soon as I can get my hands on the newer MacBook Pros, I would love to test them in future first impressions episodes for you guys. And if you'd like to help fund the future of the Computer Clan, plus get some awesome perks along the way, feel free to pledge to my Patreon. Thanks in advance for your support. And hey, if you like this episode, you know what to do. Thanks for sticking with me, catch the crazy, and pass it on.